Kuala Lumpur, the Star/Asian New Network, a 58-year-old Singaporean man who was released from a prison in the Republic was brought to a Kuala Lumpur court on Thursday, December 21, over allegations of accepting illegal deposits said to amount to RM230 million. Sunshine Empire SDNBHD founder James Fang Wok pleaded not guilty to two counts of accepting deposits without a valid license under a section of Malaysia's Banking and Financial Institutions Act. Fang, at the time of the commission of the offence, was assisting in the management of Sunshine Empire, an investment company based in Kuala Lumpur. In July 2010, a Singapore court sentenced Fang to 9 years jail and a $60,000 fine for criminal breach of trust. It described his scheme as a premeditated, sustained, sophisticated fraud on a large scale which no unsuspecting mind could have easily seen through. For 15 months between August 2006 and November 2007, thousands of unwitting Singaporeans bought almost 26,000 lifestyle packages ranging from $240 to $12,000 from the company, previous reports say. These totaled some $190 million. In the Malaysian Sessions Court on Thursday, the first charge was allegedly committed at Menara Unkang Emas in Jalan Lokayu between July 14 and October 17, 2006. The second charge is said to have been committed at Bangunankub.com, Jalan Yap Kuan Seng between October 18, 2006 and April 4, 2008. The prosecuting officer for Malaysia's Central Bank, Alvin Ong, asked the Sessions Court to fix bail at RM15 million for each of the charges. In this case, it will be proven that the deposits collected were around RM230 million, Mr. Ong told the court on Thursday. Sharisal Abdul Manan, who represented Fang, asked the court to impose a lower bail. At present, the family can only come up with between RM100,000 and RM130,000. If the bail is too high, it would defeat the purpose of bail in the first place, he said. Sessions Court Judge Haspala Adam then fixed RM1 million bail for each count. The court also ordered for the accused to provide two Malaysians residing in Kuala Lumpur or Selangor to be bailers. The case is set for mention on January 26 next year.